Sometimes. Not all the time. But sometimes I feel like Scrooge. Well, you know, not Ebenezer Scrooge, but just kind of like the Grinch. You know, okay, maybe not the Grinch, but you kind of get the idea that maybe I'm not such a Christmas cheer kind of guy. You see, I picture this season kind of like it was back in the day when first angels came to shepherds in the field and said, I bring you glad tidings of joy which shall be to all nations, that unto you born this day in the city of David, a Savior, Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. And I think of it like, okay, the people were all looking for somebody to deliver them from Roman rule. They're all looking in the wrong direction. And Jesus was out in the fields, you know, in a cave, kind of a cavern, kind of a stall. You know, the nativity scene with animals and a crèche. So they weren't looking where God was pointing. I think of it today the same way. It's a lot of times people take this season and they point at different things and they try to make it sound like, you know, well, Santa Claus is what we're not pointing at. We want to point at the manger, or we want to point at the nativity, or we want to point at the reason for the season. I don't think so. You know, I could be wrong, but I kind of think that, you know, really it's more like this is the time of year I always use for the gospel more than any other time. I kind of think about being alone with God. Oh, I don't get into big Christmas galas, you know, unless I'm working them, you know, in the behind scenes, but I think about, I don't know, you know, walking alone in a winter wonderland, you know, walking alone with God, spending some time alone at night, you know, praying. For me, it's kind of an end time, you know, kind of like that intimacy that only God can fill my need, because I'll be dissatisfied with any other trivial way of trying to satisfy that great longing I have in my soul. And so I'm not really the best to be around about Christmas time, so I'm kind of like a Grinch, kind of like a Scrooge. Because, you know, I'd really rather be in the Word of God than be out and about in divine presence. And so my wife and I adjust for that. You know, I put up Christmas decorations and, you know, put up things in the windows, you know, for Hanukkah. I don't really know what to put up for Kwanzaa. It's still kind of like, you know, haven't settled in. But for Hanukkah, even though Hanukkah is a made-up holiday, and for Christmas, even though Christmas is a made-up holiday, they're both made up. Neither one of them are real accurate. But, you know, I put up stuff for both of them, you know, and put up lights and, you know, kind of let people enjoy it, because I like to inspire people, you know, to point them in the right direction, because I think a lot of times we get pointed in the wrong direction. We don't know which way to turn. You know, like when you're down and out, you don't know which way to go out, you know, of where you're at to get out of your mood. Or when you're kind of like not into the Christmas season, are you really going to become a legalist and try to make it like, you know, you can't do Santa? Oh, come on. Maybe I enjoy Santa and the Grinch and, you know, Mr. Magoo and all the others too. Because I kind of think that you do your best, you know, you do the best you can with what you got inside. Because as you learn the Word of God, you get more inside. And as you develop your relationship with God personally, then you begin to understand how He works. You see, the world works on you. They don't work in you, they work on you. Oh, they get inside you, they kind of connive and work your way, you know, to kind of get you through the, you know, like TV and in your mind and in your thoughts and things like that. But really, only God works in you, in your soul, in your spirit. But the world works on you, you know, to make you into, you know, kind of like the pattern of what it's doing. But God works the opposite. You see, the shepherds were quite fitting the bill of what you would think of as being the first disciples. And yet, they were probably the first commissioned missionaries. And I don't think the three wise men were really thought of as being like, you know, the disciples of Jesus. And yet, they knew that Jesus was coming, or a king was coming. So you see, I kind of see a lot of similarity today. God may not be working in America as much as he might be working like in Africa, or maybe working in other parts of America, you know, like at the street level, or maybe at the gut level, where people that really need Jesus are finding him, and people that really are just kind of celebrating Jesus, you know, they're doing their worship thing, but maybe they're pointing in the wrong direction again. You know, maybe they've kind of done like Herod and, you know, all the religious people. Oh, we know Jesus is coming. Yeah, we know. We're celebrating. You know, we're doing our thing. We're having a happy church time. But I think of like Christmas really as a time where we should open our doors more so than ever before and be less about internal and more about external. You see, I've always had this idea that at Christmas time would be the time to go out into the world, you know, to do like caroling, you know, the worship. Maybe have a march, you know, or maybe have a going through the town singing and rejoicing, you know, and declaring, you know, like the old days where they used to do the traveling minstrels, you know, where they would do little skits, you know. Or, you know, just one day a year where we would just shut the church down, you know, and say, hey, forget the church building. Let's go out on the street level and be like the angels. Hey, worship the Lord. Guess what? We're celebrating. We're rejoicing. We don't have to be here inside on Sunday morning. Let's go outside and dedicate the entire world to God. Let's dance and sing. And you know, maybe I'm a Grinch. Maybe I'm more like the Avufore, you know, hanging on to hand in hand, you know, and dancing around the Christmas tree, you know. I know some of you are going to freak out about that, but go talk to God. But you know, to really be hand in hand, or maybe there should be a day where all Christians could get together and just, hey, open up the doors, you know, and let's just celebrate. I mean, they got they have marathons where thousands of people from all over the world run. Well, why couldn't we just get thousands of people from all over the world to walk, you know? How about just walk on Christmas, you know, Christmas walk? You know, kind of like they have the Easter parade, you know, you've heard of that, where they put on their top hat, you know, they walk down and they greet each other, you know. I think of a Louis Armstrong song. I see trees of green, meadows too. I see all these things, I dream of you, you know. And why couldn't we do that? Maybe on Christmas, because you see, we always pull it inside, you know. Well, we're going to sell you tickets, or we're going to drag you down to a Christmas cantata, you know, a Christmas musical where we put up a bunch of little kids singing, you know, Christmas carols, you know, instead of making it a family event, you know, where you get everybody together and you go have a hayride. Hey. You know, you can have a hayride without hay. You just have to say, hey, it's bad hour. No, you just have to go, hey, let's go. Let's do it. Let's enjoy it. Let's get through it, you know. Let's don't be the stage, the building, the setting, you know, where everybody expects, you know, a certain amount of whoa. And, you know, that's God, you know, because it's in the church. But let's go outside where we see the heavens opened up. Where at night we see the revelation of God Almighty with his angels singing from the heavens, declaring, angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echoing the joyous refrain. Now I know, it's just me. So you see, I'll probably be inside. No, I won't be to church, because I don't like church at Christmas time or Easter time, because I think it's all programmed. And I just don't like these programs that seem to be programmed. But, hey, you know, if you happen to have, you know, some hayride going on, you know, and you want somebody that just bellows out at the top of his voice, you know, shouting and dancing and singing and laughing and carrying on, you could see me. I'm one of those kind of guys. But you see, there was a time I remember as a Jesus freak, a long time ago, where I had just got done watching Godspell. And Godspell's my favorite movie, by the way, of all time, besides Jesus of Nazareth. And I just got done watching it, and I was singing, Prepare ye the way of the Lord. And I was on my bicycle, and I was riding my bike just belling out. My back was up and my face was to the sky, and I was just singing as loud as I could, no handle, and not holding on to the handlebars. And I was just blessed out of my mind, out of my gourd. I was in Modesto at the time. And I just loved it. And you know, why couldn't we all just rejoice outside the church as much as we rejoice inside the church? Maybe then I'd be more Christmassy and not so much a Grinch. Because I'm not trying to steal Christmas away from all the celebrations that churches do. But I am trying to say, hey, you know what? There may be more to what we're pointing at and where we're directing our hearts at this time of year than just the simple, normal, you know, cantatas and musicals and presentations that everybody's expecting. And we always put little kids up, you know, and spectacles on stage, you know, our worship leaders and worship teams and, you know, all the little things. Oh, well, we got to prepare and get all the stuff ready. What if we just grabbed everybody and said, hey, you know, we canceled Christmas. Come on, we're all going, you know. Let's just leave the cars in the parking lot. We got, you know, this big flatbed. You know, we're all going to just get on board, you know, and we're going to go sing it. We'll even set up chairs for you for those that want to sit down, you know. Maybe a few bales of hay, you know. Just get on board and go, you know. Wouldn't that be something if the body of Christ could just go, you know, like the shepherds when they were tending their sheep saw the angels singing from heaven and they just went? Wouldn't that be something, you know? And then meet all someplace at some central park, you know, and just, hey, have a mini worship service of everybody without any big major programming and planning. So much for that idea. In the Jesus moment, it was probably easier to do, but you know, I'd like to see a flash mob like that, where you just say, hey, we're all getting on, you know, one of these trailers, and we're all heading out to praise the Lord. Now, to me, that's my Christmas wish. And you know, that just might be my Christmas cheer, if someday somebody wanted to bring a tear to my eye and show me that that could be done. Because I think that's more in line with what the name of the Son of God is all about. In this time and season that we celebrate, or we declare that God has brought us glad tidings of great joy.